We're taking a look outside right now. The DHR camera in Edinburgh. Kind of a quiet night. A little bit still on the warm side out there. 79 degrees. Clear skies off that high temperature of 93 degrees. Low humidity. Yep, that is a muggy night out there. And do expect that to continue into the morning hours. Now, in terms of temperatures across the valley, 79 degrees in McAllen, 78 in Harlingen, 79 in Brownsville. How about still in the 80s out in Stark County for you at this hour? Though, over the next couple hours, we'll be cooling into the lower 70s. Mostly cloudy skies, so we are going to see the clouds building in throughout the night. We're also going to see the chance for some patchy fog. The only limiting factor is we got a little bit of a breeze out there, 10 to 15, and the wind stays up, less fog out there. If the wind comes down, we could see a little bit more widespread fog, something to keep an eye on there. 73 degrees is going to be that bottom out mark for us, though we will quickly start to warm up through the morning hours, up to 76 degrees there by 8 o'clock in the morning, and quickly warm from there. Why is that? Well, we got what we call a dry line moving across South Texas, and that's going to really lower the humidity, especially in the upper valley. Responding to that is the temperatures, and they're going to be skyrocketing throughout the day. Plus, its proximity is also going to help kick up the winds out of the south, and that's going to also bring in the warmer temperatures throughout the day, and plenty of sunshine out there later on in the afternoon. So it's going to be a warm, sunny, breezy day across South Texas. Let's take a look at the hour by hour, looking at about 90 degrees there by noontime, 97 by 3 o'clock. Take a look at the whole valley, though. We're talking 101 tomorrow in McAllen, 108 actual temperature out in Rio Grande City, 100 in Edinburgh as well. Normal temperature this time of year, 88 degrees out there across the valley. Now, you add in the humidity, now we're talking triple digits, feels like temperatures all across the valley, 105 to 110, depending on where you're at. So, please stay cool tomorrow. Check the back seat of your vehicle. That means for the kids, your pets, you name it. Staying hydrated if you're going to be working outside. Check your pets also. Make sure that they have shade. Check the AC filter as well. You don't want that conking out, especially when you have a hot day. And if you're going to be outside with all that sunshine, make sure you do wear the sunscreen. Also, we're going to have quite a bit of wind out there. South winds, 20, 25, gusting 35, possibly as high as 40 miles an hour up along our coastal communities. Something to keep an eye on there. So, yeah, kind of a hair dryer kind of day. So if you're looking to cool off, maybe head off to the island, 85 degrees there, plenty of sunshine. Still be a bit of a breeze, but not nearly as hot as we're going to be seeing inland. That's good news on that front. Now, we are going to see that dry line recede, and what comes after it? Well, we are going to be seeing a cold front. Well, I should call it cold. It's going to be cooler as that moves south. It does bring in a chance of showers, though very small chance, and behind it, right back to that drier air, though a little bit cooler as we get in towards Cinco de Mayo. Again, that's going to be on Wednesday for us, but at least it cools us off. We go from 97 there on Monday, 84 there on Wednesday, again for Cinco de Mayo, and then we'll slowly climb the ladder back up to near 90 for the weekend. That's going to be breezy conditions for the Mother's Day holiday, and that's right, Mother's Day is Sunday. Don't forget to make sure you take care of your mother this weekend.